Namaste, dear ones. Lisa A. Romano here, wanting to talk to you today about what happens in our relationships when we begin to start dealing with our own codependent issues. A viewer recently got in touch with me, sent me an email, and asked the question, like, you know, Lisa, I am beginning to become aware that I'm codependent, that I tone myself down, that I don't tell my husband exactly how I feel. He asks me where I want to go to dinner, and I don't have an answer, and all I want to do is make sure that we go where he wants to go, and I don't want to upset him. And I'm beginning to realize that I do that a lot, and I never, you know, the kids leave dishes in the sink, and I stuff it, and I quietly, you know, get angry, and I begin to resent them. But the reality is that, you know, I'm not telling my truth, and so I'm wondering, you know, how I can navigate these newfound ideas that I'm playing with in my mind about my own codependency issues. So thank you very much for the question, number one, dear one. Now, what I'd like to do is just explain really what happens in the mind of someone who's become consciously aware that they're codependent. It is an amazing time, but it's also a very confusing time. I know for myself, when I became aware that I was codependent, I was already married almost 12 years, and I had 3 children. I was very unhappily married. At that point, I had so much rage and anger towards my first husband because nothing I ever did was good enough. That was one issue. But what was really going on was that I wasn't showing up as my real self. I was so worried what my neighbors thought of our house and what my family thought of my family. And I was so worried about what my husband thought about me. And I was so worried about what my kids' teachers thought about them. And of course, how that reflected on me. Hoo-hoo. You know, I was so worried all the time that my mind had so much mental chatter going on. And it was constantly trying to control all these dynamics outside of myself, that I really lost myself. And so, you know, I had these unconscious ideas going on in my head and belief systems that, you know, if I clean the house a certain way, then when my husband comes home, he's going to validate me and I'm going to feel really good. You know, I'm going to get a gold star and then everything's going to be right. Everything's going to be perfect. But, and so when that didn't happen, when my husband came home from work and he was like, hey, what's for dinner? I felt completely like, oh my God, he doesn't even notice me. He doesn't pay attention to me. Oh. And I would go off into this tirade and this tizzy. I'm being dramatic. It wasn't that bad, but on days it was. But I would really feel offended and wounded because he didn't pay attention to these things that I was trying to do for him. And so when I became aware that I wasn't doing those things for him, I was doing those things for me. I was doing those things because I was hoping to manipulate a sense of approval from him and thus satisfy this dysfunctional neediness that I had to be validated from outside of self. And that was quite humbling, dear one. It was like, boom, it was like a sledgehammer between my eyes that all this whining and all this complaining that I had done about how he didn't pay attention to my feelings, and which was true, absolutely true. Couldn't care less about how I felt, you know, which doesn't take away from my own need to be true to myself and to show up completely honest in my own mind and with my own self and say, hey, you know, you got to wear this. Like, you are codependent and you've been manipulating a sense of validation from this man. And when he doesn't give it to you, you take the victim position. You take the offended position. And it was very humbling. So that's what happens. There's a lot of that going on. You know, when you begin to become aware that you're codependent and you're trying to manipulate a sense of validation from everybody. And so it's scary because you got to face that stuff. And then you sort of deal with like, well, When do I have a right to be pissed off at my husband? When do I do have a right to be pissed off at my kids? So it's a real confusing time. But this is what happens. If you have a relationship that is truly, truly loving and it's based on authenticity, or as much as you're aware of being authentic. And you're married to Joe Schmo, and he's a nice guy, and he cares. He really does care about how you feel. It's just, it's not his fault that you don't tell him how you feel. So if that's your situation, you would present yourself to Joe Schmo, your husband, and you say, so babe, listen, you know, I've been watching this, you know, this woman on YouTube, this ACOE life coach, and I've learned that I'm codependent and that I play the victim a lot. And then a lot of that has to do with me not being honest and me never getting the validation I needed from my mother and my father and blah, 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 blah. And so I'm going to really try to start showing up with to you as an honest being. You know, can you support me on that? The way he answers is everything. If Joe Schmo says, babe, no problem. I'm here for you. Like, I don't want you to not tell me the truth. I don't want you to not be yourself. I don't want you to minimize yourself. I don't want you to make everything about me. I don't want that. I want to know who you are. I want you to feel good in your own skin. I want us to have a real marriage. That's a keeper. That's a keeper, okay? So that's a good guy, very aware, and your relationship is going to be off the charts. And you're going to be fine, especially if you keep him abreast of what you're telling, going through. So tell him what you're going through. Don't hold back. Having a tough day? Tell him. Now, if you talk to Joe Schmo, and he's like, my Joe Schmo, my first husband, you're going to hear something like this. What do you mean you're codependent? What do you mean you're going to change? What do you mean things around here are going to change? What do you mean you're going to start telling me how you feel? What do you mean you're not going to buy my shaving cream anymore? What do you mean you're not picking out my sneakers for me anymore? What do you mean you expect me to pick the towel up off the floor? That's your job. That's your job. That's ridiculous. I like things just the way you are, the way they are. I'm not going to change. You're headed for trouble. But that's a good thing because it's tough. I'm going to tell you right now, it's tough, especially when you're codependent and you're dealing with someone. You're coming into this wonderful awakening of yourself and you're dealing with someone who's like, oh, hell no, I'm not changing. It's so scary when you're codependent because you're looking at the demise of your relationship right in front of your face because now you come to a fork in the road. Like, what do I do? Do I stay with him or do I go? You don't know where you're going and you're terrified to be alone, but staying here, you know, it's like death. It's a spiritual death. So it's really, really scary. So I just want to address that in this video because I could go on forever about what we're supposed to do next. But I hope that that helps enlighten you a little bit, makes you a little bit more aware of what could happen and the dynamics of how it is to feel responsible for your own partner, a dysfunctional relationship, and what goes through your mind when you begin to deal with those issues. So namaste, dear one. Everything's going to be fine. You just keep rising. You just keep transcending, and everything's going to be fine. For more inspiration, please check out my channel, and please check out my website at www.healingselfesteem.com. I'm also the author of The Road Back to Me, My Road Beyond the Codependent Divorce, Loving the Self-Affirmations, and Quantum Tools to Help You Heal Your Life Now. I'll be talking to you soon. Namaste, everybody.